Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see the CBSE class 10 math question paper analysis for term 1. Okay, so the exam just concluded today and we are going to see what are the types of questions that were asked in this particular exam and what did the teachers and the students think about this paper, and we will be also looking at the marks distribution and chapter wise question distribution for this paper. So let's begin by understanding about the paper. Okay, so the paper had the following pattern. Okay, so the question paper consisted of three sections A, B and C. Each section was compulsory, you needed to attempt all the three sections. Okay, so section A consisted of 20 questions. So questions are in the form of MCQs with options which had 1 mark each, and you need to attempt only 16 out of 20 from the section A. Similarly, from section B, you need to attempt any 16 out of 20 similar MCQs you will find, and each MCQs are of 1 mark each. In section C, you have 10 questions based on 2 case studies. Okay, so there will be 10 questions, 5-5 each, and you have to attempt any 8 out of the 10 questions available. Okay, also there is no negative marking for this paper. You can attempt all the questions and there won't be any negative marking. Also, all the MCQs will be having only one correct option. If you mark multiple options, then you won't be getting any mark there. Okay, so you need to mark only one option for each question. Moving on to chapter wise marks distribution, you can see we have divided the entire paper in terms of marks over here. So we had 20% marks coming from the chapter Introduction to Trigonometry, followed by coordinate geometry, which had 18%, and then real numbers 14%. Okay, we also had polynomials coming at 12%, then followed by pair of linear equations in two variables, then areas related to circles, and you can see probability and triangles had the least number of questions, so they had the least number of marks. The same thing can be reflected over here, chapter wise questions. Okay, so you can see as there are more marks, there will be more questions because each question having only 1 mark each. Okay, so you will expect more questions here for Introduction to Trigonometry, followed by coordinate geometry, and you find the similar pattern over here because you have only 1 mark question each. So moving on to conclusion, this paper, according to many teachers, it was a balanced paper. It had questions which were difficult and also had questions that were easy. Students found this paper a bit difficult and time consuming also. Also, the teachers too agreed that the paper was time consuming because you had to attempt 50 questions, and each questions you were required to think differently, because in previous case you had a question with 3 marks and 4 marks. So if you are thinking about a question, you at the end of the question you will be getting 4 marks. But here the time that you are going to spend in thinking about the question and solving that will only fetch you 1 mark each, and you need to attempt the questions to get the marks. Okay, so that was time consuming because students need to think every time they face a new question, and in the end they will be getting only 1 mark. So time management would be a problem here if you haven't practiced well. Okay, and we too here at Topper Learning believe that it was a time consuming paper and you needed to manage your time properly in order to complete this paper completely. Now more weightage was given to the continuing chapters, which will be seen in term 2. So the emphasis was given on that because we need to have a good understanding of these chapters going to the term 2. So that was all about the analysis of term 1 CBSE class 10 math paper. Hope this video was helpful to you. For any doubts and query, you can connect with us at topperlearning.com. See you in the next video. Thank you.